Good morning, students. Our today's topic is going to be on sanitary appliances. We are going to take sanitary appliances because in the previous lecture, we discussed on cold water supply system, hot water supply system. And when we talk about hot water supply systems, in the picture we have the diagram we have shown. We have shown some various fittings and various appliances that are demonstrated in the building. So today, we are going to discuss sanitary appliances and the fittings. Now, we will now look at the sanitary appliances and look at, after discussing the sanitary appliances, teaching them what are the expected objectives that are supposed to be achieved at the end of the lesson. One, the student should be able to describe what is a sanitary appliance. When they say sanitary appliances, what does it mean to a student? Two, the student should be able to list the types of sanitary appliances we have in our homes. Three, the student should be able to describe these sanitary appliances we have listed. When you see these sanitary appliances anywhere, you should be able to describe it. What does that mean? Four, we should also look at state the constitutional requirements for installing sanitary appliances. After describing the requirement, we should be able to mention what are the materials used in manufacturing these sanitary appliances. And lastly, we should be able to describe the fittings used in connecting these sanitary appliances. And to achieve this, you will now see where we are going to take this content, one after the other. Now, we are going to look at sanitary appliances. First of all, when we hear the word sanitary appliances, what does that mean? Sanitary appliances simply means all the fittings that are available in our home to convey the waste matters from the human body and the wastewaters around our home. All those appliances that are used to convey all those waste from home, they are called sanitary appliances. They are called what? Sanitary appliances. We have so many of them. But before then, we will try to look at the classifications of sanitary appliances. When we talk of sanitary appliances, we are also thinking of classifying them. Because two, there are waste that comes from human body. That is called what? A soil waste. Those appliances that are used to convey waste from human body are called a soil appliances. But you also see those that are categorized under the soil appliances. The ones that are categorized under the soil appliances include the WC and the urinal. The WC and the urinal. If you look at when they say waste appliances, those that carry surface water, carry water, we use the bath, we wash our hands, all those water that are wasted at home, after use, you want to pour them away, you want to remove them, channel them to the drainage, they are called what? The waste water. And those category, we look at the bath, we look at water from the washhand basins, we look at water from, all those appliances are categorized as waste appliances. Having heard about all those waste appliances, it is important for you to know the basic appliances that are categorized under soil and waste. One, we have WC, we have urinal, all those two are there under the soil appliances. bidet, shower, wash hand basin, sink. All these ones are categorized under waste appliances. Those are the common type of sanitary appliances we have in our homes. And those are the ones we shall now discuss in this class. We'll be able to look at them one after the other. Somebody in his home doesn't have much of these appliances. Those in the rural areas, you find that basically out of these ones, they don't even have any. Now, the description will now go look at where they are fixed and their purposes. The sanitary appliances we have mentioned in the last week, the one we are seeing, the one I'm touching here, is a typical wash hand basin. The wash hand basin you have seen, it has a bowl. If you look at the wash hand basin, it has a tap. It has a tap. If you look at this place here, it is called an overflow. What is overflow? Is that the wash hand basin, when you own the tap here, and eventually you are not closed, you have forgotten to close it. When this place got filled, you must take the water now. Escape through this overflow. Now, what is the use of wash hand basin? As the name implies, it is where we wash our hand after using our toilets or after eating our food. We will find them sometimes in the dining. You can also find them in the kitchen. When you have finished cooking, your hand is stained by oil, by any other things you use in the kitchen. You can go to wash hand basin on the tap, the water flows, and you wash your hand in it. That is the purpose of wash hand basin. This wash hand basin, you see, it is looking very shiny. It is something that it is not allow the passage of water, the moisture, and when you look at it, it is in form of a ceramic material. Very shiny, and it is used also for beautification because it beautifies the house. So this is a typical wash hand basin. This is another waste appliances, and this is called a shower. This is called a shower. This is the shower head here. What is shower used for? And as you have seen, after you have come back home before you go to work, you want to take your bath, or you have just returned from work, or you want to go to bed, you want to take your bath. Here, it's connected here to water. Like I have said here in the last one, direct water supply or hot water supply. This is one of the features of hot water supply. If you want to bath with cold water, in some of the shower here, we will have double, one for the cold, one for the hot. But this one you are seeing here is just a cold water supply. It supplies only cold water. When you go to you want to bath, when you on this way, this direction here, now water for this shower bed here will start coming your shower home. If you want to bath, you will now stand here, you will naked yourself, or whatever way you want to do, you will now stand here and the water comes in the shower way, you wash and you help yourself in washing, in bathing, you take care of your body. If you want to off it, you off it this way. This, in case, this is the common type of shower we have in our domestic building. But in other places, like I have said, you will see the shower here. If you want the control valve here you are having here, it will help you here the tap. If you turn it this side, it's going to give you cold water. If you turn it the other side, it's going to give you hot water. But this one here only provides cold water. And this is used
or bathroom. If you bath here, when you look at it, you find there is a drain here. The drain here will help in draining the water you have used in the bathroom here. It will help this one to drain it down to the disposal unit. This is a typical shower you can see in our home. Okay. The next one we are going to see here is the picture of a bath. What is a bath? You have seen, just as I was describing, one of the worst appliances, I said it is the shower. In the bathroom, we have a kind of a bowl. A bowl, a very big one, that one can sit in to take his own bath. That bath here is not the same with shower. Shower is up. The bath is fixed on the floor that will allow the user to sit on inside it or to stand inside it and take his bath. So the ones there, they are commonly used in the hotels, in our homes, and other recreational areas. So you will now see the picture of the bath. In the bath, you see also where there's called the overcoat, up there. There's also down there that we call the drain. You remove the cover of the drain, anytime you are taking bath, you remove that thing, it will just drain away the water content you have reserved in the bath. In the bath, it is not really using the shower. There is a tap that is fixed to the bath. There is a tap fixed to the bath that you can collect your water for bathing. And that is where sometimes you will see there are two tap fixed there. You can see a tap that is bringing out cold water. You can see a tap that is bringing out hot water. In that system where you look up, you will now see a boiler, a cylinder and a boiler that is sitting water. If you want to use hot water, you can now use it. If you want to use cold water, when you turn the tap to, you can now also get your cold water. And that can help you to this. And you use within that place now to take your bath and drain the water away. That is a typical bath. You can now see the picture here showing a picture of a bath. Also, the next one we are going to discuss is the sink. What is a sink? When we talk of a sink, we mean an appliance fixed basically in the kitchen. It is fixed mostly in the kitchen where we have access to take our potable water. That is where we now take in our potable water. Is also an appliance categorized under waste appliances. It's categorized under waste appliances. Sometimes you see them in a steel form, you see them maybe in a ceramic form, but mostly we see them in a steel form, where it is also used for drying our wash plate. Whatever a plate we have, if you have washed a plate, in the kitchen we want to dry them, we use the sink now to dry our. You will now see the difference between a sink and a wash hand basin. It is that sink here would not allow waste material to go through that place. But ordinarily, you see, you want to take cold water, you want to take your potable water for drinking, that is where you go to take your potable water for drinking. You want to take water for cooking, that is where you go there to take your water for cooking in the kitchen. So the sink is wider. It's longer compared to the washhand basin. You see it fits flat on the table. It's just like when you look at kitchen cabinet. You look at it laid flat on it. And that is where we dry our pot, we take our drinkable water. That is called You see the picture here. This is a picture, you know, showing a typical scene. Now, the last one we have is called the bidet. Now, the bidet, it is not too common, but it's also a sanitary appliance. We sometimes, in the bidet, we sit down after we have used all our this, you just go and sit down to wash your hands. That is the essence of the bidet. It is only there to wash your body and not for any other purposes. That is not too common, but we have them mostly in our sanitary appliances like the toilet. We used to see them a bidet. And you see the pictures of a bidet showing you the true picture of a bidet. This is called urina. The urina here, it is one of the appliances I have mentioned in the last one. What is urina? The urina here, it is an appliance used for conveying urine product from human body down to the drain. If you look at the urina here, the content, the first here you are seeing here, it is called a hole. There is a hole here. The holes here, when you urine, it passes through here. But when after you have finished the urine from human body, you now press this this point here. When you press it, it now brings out water to flush down the urine filter. When you press here, you cannot release. As you press, it will just bring out water to flush the urine. There are also some that is known as, there you will see there is a water tank fixed up here. But for this one here, the water tank is not fixed here, it's automatic from here. You will now press and close. The water tank here, you see where you press here, it is built on the wall here that will help in flushing the urine product down to the drain to the soak away or safety and safety tank. This is the purpose of the urina here. Now, you will now have a look of this is a typical WC used in our home. You look at it, it's just like a squat one. You squat on top of it. This is the front here is called the pan. This is the cover. This is a typical WC you have seen here. It's used in disposing our waste. Now, when you are pressed, you go to the toilet. You sit on the tray here, which is called the WC. Mostly WC is called what? It's called water closet. The meaning of WC is called the water closet. The water closet is used for excretion. Specifically, when you finish using the water, when you finish the excretion, you require the waste to be flushed. And exactly what you are seeing top here, it is called what? The flushing system. It's called the flushing system. Now, in the system you are seeing here now, the system here has contains water. The water, most of the water is about 5 liters or maximally we have up to 9 liters. When here it is automatically done, it's done in such a way that when you finish the excretion, you will only place this part of the system, and when you press it down, water comes out of it. You see, the water now will now come automatically to flush the waste that you have seen here. Now, when the liver rises up, it will now bring out the water. Now, when the water got finished here, automatically, when there's water flows in the house now, the system will be refilled. That is the essence of the WC. For disposal of waste. Having discussed all the sanitary appliances, one will now look at how this, from what material are these sanitary appliances and what are the constructional requirements for putting a sanitary appliance. All the material we have mentioned, all these appliances we have mentioned, they are made from one material or the other.
But what the constitutional requirement says about all in trying to install these sanitary appliances. The sanitary appliances I've mentioned here, they are installed by professionals. One, that for you to install any sanitary appliances, you have to go to see the building, ask of the numbers of people who are going to use and how it is going to be flushed. Two, that the materials you are going to use must be able to cleanse all the waste material and flush it down to the drain. Three, that the material must not be corrosive. If the material is corrosive, it is not a good material for what? For the sanitary appliances. The material must be a non-absorbent. That is, it must not absorb moisture. Materials you are going to use, either those are the requirement that you must use a non-absorbent material. That any material that is going to absorb moisture must not be used. Those are the constitutional requirement. Now, if you have seen how the constitutional requirement, the next is what are those appliances meant for? One, the common, if you look at the materials used for the sanitary appliances, you find they are shiny materials. They are looking so clean, so shiny, in different colors. Some of them, one of the examples of the material used is called the ceramic. The ceramic is one of the good material used for manufacturing of these sanitary appliances. Example, most of the WC we see around are made from ceramics. If you also look at the urina, I have just shown you here, it is also made from a ceramic. You also see the bath. The bath, most of them are also made from a ceramic. Other material we have is what? The vitreous enamel cast iron. The cast iron is also a good material because it's a non-absorbent material and it is also a non-corrosive material and it can also clean very well. The other one you have, the enamel press steel. If you look at this typical sink, the enamel press steel, the sink is there, it's made from a steel material. Look at the sink there, you find it is made from that material. So it is always when it is oily, you can always clean it. And it's always clean, can always be cleaned. It cannot absorb water, so it is a very good material for the sanitary appliances. Lastly, we have the plastic material. The plastic material is also a good material for what? For the sanitary appliances. What is it? When we talk about even the plastic is also commonly used in sanitary work. Even the piping itself, the piping is also, but particularly when we talk about the sanitary appliances, you find there are some that are made from plastic because one, it can always clean. Two, it is always non-absorbent. So those are the common materials we have for the manufacturing of these sanitary appliances I have mentioned. Now, you cannot find them in the market. When you go to the market, you now look at the materials you have. You now look at the material, you find all the material used for this fall under this category. After I have listed the materials and the construction requirement, it is all about the sanitary appliances. We shall now go to see what are those fittings used in the connecting these sanitary appliances. We are now going to discuss on fittings and their uses. After discussing all the sanitary appliances, in our demonstration we saw that most of these sanitary appliances were connected to pipes. What is a pipe? I said pipes are hollow cylinders used for conveying material, either liquid or any other material. For the purpose of this course, the pipes there are there to convey whether the soil matters or the waste matters from our home. Now, with the fittings we are going to discuss today are one, the elbow, two, the coupling, 3, we have the union. 4, we have the reducer. 5, we have the cap. 6, we have the cross. Now, let's look at elbow. This is a clear picture of our elbow. Elbow is a form of a kind of a bend. This is a fitting that connects two pipes together at the angle 90. When a pipe is going these directions and the other one is coming this direction, the only thing to connect the two of them, it is called the elbow. It is called what? The elbow at a corner of angle 90. You will now see the drawing. Also, we have the coupling. The coupling is a fittings used to connect one or two pipes together. For instance, you are taking a pipe to the next room, and the pipe you are using here, connecting here, is not long enough to connect to the other room. You need a coupler to connect the two. The coupler now is used to connect the two. If you look at the union, in between, you see the union and the coupling, they are similar. But the union is there at the center to connect the two pipes, maybe in different directions. To connect them in different directions. The reducer is also a kind of a fittings used in connecting one or two. One, possibly the other one is 12 mm, and the other one, the other pipe is 14 mm or 20 mm. The union cannot connect the two of them. Now we now use a reducer that one head will be large and the other one will be smaller. So it's connecting the bigger head and the smaller one. The cross. Sometimes you see in a piping, there is a pipe crossing, the one is going this way, and there is a pipe joining at a point. What do we use? We now use the cross to connect the pipes that are coming. The ones that are going this way, and the one that is joining at that point. So that is what is called the cross. We have also seen where we connect a pipe, and the pipe goes to a point. It is no longer going to any place. We want to stop the water at that point. We want to stop the movement of the water. When it goes to that place, that is where the water will stop. The movement of the water stops ends at that place. We don't use any other connection. The only fittings we can use in stopping the pipe here is called the cap. So the cap is used to stop the movement of water at a point. So when the waters, the pipe stop at that point, we will now use the cap to close it, to stop the movement of water at that point. So those are the common fittings we have, and they are used in our connections of sanitary appliances. We also have the valves. The taps are there. The taps are there in our home. When we want to take water, we take water from the tap. We on and off. The on and off. So those, that is also a good fittings we use in our home. So for this lecture, you have learned about the various fittings and their uses when we want to fix our sanitary appliances. In the next, we are going to see here the questions. We are going to pose some questions in the next clip to enable you answer. And when you answer this question, you will now post this answer in my email. So the next clip is going to pose the question for you, and I will give you my email in the next clip. Thank you. After you have watched these clips, the student should answer the following questions. List 4 worst appliances. List 4 types of worst appliances. Number 2, list 2 types of soil appliances. List 2 types of soil appliances. State number 3, state the use of WC. state the use of WC. Mention four materials used in manufacturing sanitary appliances. Mention four materials used in manufacturing our sanitary appliances. After answering the question, you should send the answers to my email. And the email address is muazzinbejicoe@gmail.com. muazzinbejicoe@gmail.com. From the beginning of this lesson, titled Sanitary Appliances and Fittings, we discussed what is sanitary appliances and how we can classify sanitary appliances. We said they can be classified into two: the soil appliances and that of the waste appliances. Under the waste appliances, we said urinal, bidet, shower, bath, sink, all those are waste appliances. We also look at the soil appliances to include the urinal and that of the water closet, WC. Now we look at what are the constitutional requirements of installing these appliances. One, that the material must not be water absorbent, and the material should also be able to clean without much stress. When it is stained, it should be clean. Used, it will be very easy to clean. And also, the material to be used must be non-corrosive. It must be a non-corrosive material. And also, we were able to discuss the basic materials we are going to use for the manufacturing of these sanitary appliances. They include, one, the plastic material. We also have ceramic as a good material. We have the vitreous enamel pre-stressed steel. We also have enameled cast iron. So all those materials we have mentioned in the class are very good example of material used in manufacturing the sanitary appliances. Lastly, when we were discussing, I said, having learned about the appliances, what they are used for, how they are installed, we will come to look at what are those fittings used in connecting the H-pipe. Because when you go to where they are used, you will surely see how they are connected to a pipe and what are those fittings we use. In bringing water to your home, you will ask of, we have the elbow, we have the coupling, we have the cap, we have the cross, we have the reducer, we have also the union. I have mentioned them, and I was able to describe their basic function. The elbow, I say, is used to join pipes, two pipes at an angle 90. I say reducer, it helps to reducing maybe a bigger pipe, a smaller pipe. I also say a cross, one pipe joins at a point. So those are the pipes and also the fittings and their uses in the sanitary appliances. I hope that after you have gone through this work successfully, watch the clips up and on at your own convenient time, that a business student should be able to suggest to his client or be able to supervise correctly or be able to make a decision on the use of any of these sanitary appliances in his future endeavor. Thank you for listening and for watching this video. So, the student, you can watch the video at your own convenient time anywhere through the YouTube, and you see, and I appreciate watching the videos.